down here at the bottom right-hand corner of the map in Toon Valley, we have our red Zerg player from Team Liquid, their final representative. It is Liquid TLO. And his opponent here in the upper right-hand corner.
What is QXC doing in here?
QXCU, get out.
Get out.
Get out.
Out of here.
It's Lars Brown up here in the top right-hand corner. He's our blue Protoss, and looking to close things out right here for Slayers. This would be just the kind of victory that Slayers needs as well, because they are 1-1 at the moment. If you go 2-1, you know, MVP still has to play Liquid. MVP still has to play EG, and there could be a three-way tie situation for first place overall. And if that's the case, it will come down to map score. And this would be a great way to get your team out there.
I'm really curious now, actually, if that's QXC or if it's someone else. Because TLO and Brown are both in Korea, I'm wondering if Complex8QXC is just someone that, you know, has a Korean account that he said, you guys, you know, one of your managers or somebody can hop on and spec the game. Or if it's actually QXC just being a troll, I have no idea. Either way, kind of surprising to see his name pop up in chat. Bumblebee is the Liquid manager. That's why TLO is playing as Bumblebee. I'm really confused on what server they're playing this on, because TLO should have his own account on all three, I would imagine.
I would imagine, too. And Bumblebee is, well, Robin, of course, their manager, and he's based out of Europe, so possibly this is on the EU server.
But
I'm not sure.
TLO have an
I'm not
EU
sure.
account?
Yeah, but he should have an EU account as well, but that was my best guess when I saw Bumblebee, so I'm not actually sure.
Oh, well, either way, should be a good game. Looks like Brown has already discovered everything TLO is up to, so TLO, I'm not sure if he's actually managed to get the scout on yet. It looks like he has not. He's actually going to send his drone out to scout that bottom left location, but obviously the Overlord is going to see everything in just a moment, so he can double back and actually hide that drone near the third base in case... Oh, actually, he's just going to go straight for that third base instead.
He saw the probe down there and didn't even want to mess with it, and saw the forge first, which meant that there was a likely pylon block that could happen, so he's just going to produce a couple of Zerglings. That's going to force Brown to check things out once again and make sure nothing up is weird that's escaping his notice.
Nothing up is weird indeed, and he's got a couple of a couple of Zlings are already out chasing down this probe. I'm sure he's going to double back over toward that third base location just to make sure he can find that hatchery. TLO says he doesn't really care about that probe so much. He's going to go check out the front of Brown once more, and the probe is actually going to double back, but another hatch was dropped by TLO, so that's going to put him on three bases in 4 minutes.
And, you know, thus far, Brown has played two Zerg players. He has also decided to go Stargate twice. Mm-hmm. And TLO not going to be able to bust his way through, I think, in the time that he needs. And yes, the Proton Cannon is up, takes the Zergling with him. Did force an equivalent amount of resources out of his opponent, actually 62 minerals, if you want to think of it that way, I suppose. But he only lost 25 himself, so not the worst trade. And Brown does hold on.
All right, so Brown still just sticking to what he's been doing. Would not be surprised to see a Stargate after the Cybernetics Core gets finished up, as those Phoenixes and Void Rays actually have both been successful for him so far. This map, Entombed Valley, the flight distance is kind of long, so I would actually expect Phoenixes over Void Rays in this situation, but, you know, still a possibility. If there are some destructible rocks around, for example, between the main here and the third, Void Rays can make use of that to try and power down a hatchery pretty quickly.
Okay, and Brown could actually switch things up on us too and decide to not go for a Stargate strategy, but it's worked against two Liquid Zergs so far. It may very well work against a third. So taking a look at things, three bases just finishing up now for TLO. Of course, in a little while here, once he gets up to about 35 drones or so, he'll double gas and then start working towards his upper tech after another round of drones after that. Cybernetics Core is done, plus one weapons and a warp gate are on the way, and that did use or occupy a good portion of his gas. No third and fourth gas quite yet, no hint of tech.
All right, well, possibly he will be switching it up to just more gateways or something like that after TLO has witnessed, you know, the builds that he did in the previous games against Xenio and Sheth. He actually got a look at some of the things Brown has been doing. Obviously, they've discussed what kind of builds he's been doing against them, so TLO has an opportunity to try and rewrite things here and avoid dying to Stargates.
One gate, three Nexus coming up for Brown, though. He's feeling very confident at the moment. He will full wall this off with nothing but Gateway's here in just a second. That's Gateway number two. Three and four will be here momentarily. And thus far, I think TLO has seen this. Yeah, he did see the edge of the Nexus forming in, so he knows exactly what's up.
All right, so TLO is going to actually come figure out everything in just a moment with this Ling. He's going to see the three gates. He knows that that third base is being constructed and the destructible rocks are being taken out because he can hear it and see it with that Ling that is now about to die. So TLO, I wonder if he's going to switch anything up. Lair is about halfway done. Roach Warren just got started not long ago. Does he have Lings? Yes, he does have Lings biting away at the destructible rocks there, so he can join his bases eventually. And yeah, they're nearly finished. So two more gas going up for Brown now. He is getting a Twilight Council first up in the way of Tech.
You know, TLO could decide to play really aggressively after this, decide that his opponent won't have that many forces out there, maybe do that big Roach play. It's not something you see too much anymore, though, because Protoss players have become especially adept at holding those off, especially with just a couple of sentries and a couple of Immortals. But it is still a consideration for TLO. So that Twilight Council, as you mentioned, is just about finished, and it's going to time perfectly, I mean, down to the second, with being able to produce plus two, and there it goes.
All right, so Brown, with a very tight build order here, has not been under any real pressure so far, so he can continue doing what he wants to do. TLO is getting Zergling speed, plus one melee, and Roach speed all at the same time now, while adding on two more hatcheries, one as this fourth base and one as a macro hatch by his third base, actually. So, yeah, just not sure why this one drone is selected.
Yeah.
Yep. Either way, we've got a couple of stalkers taking out. What was that, actually, over there?
Overseer.
Oh, just the Overseer. Nice.
Yep.
Okay.
There was really nothing happening on the map,
yeah.
So just watching the path of one drone as he makes his way out. But with five more gateways on the way, I'm sorry, six more. It's going to be 10 gates, all Blink Ooh. Stalkers with plus two. Maybe this is the advanced version of the what was the six gate Blink Stalker two base build.
Yeah, it's the 10 gate Stalker, etc.
Three base build.
So we'll see with plus two upgrades how well he's actually going to be able to do here against TLO. TLO still primarily with just Lings on the field. He is building a Spire now and getting Pathogen Gland, so he's spreading his tech in several different directions. I'm curious if he's going to have the fighting forces necessary to deal with 10 gateways worth of Blink Stalkers here soon, though.
No Hive on the way, so not planning Broodlords quite yet for that Spire. It's going to be a while before that happens. And as we can see, the resources are just, this is kind of a clever build from Brown. I really like this. I mean, it's a lot of stalkers you can produce at the same time. He's turning over six more gateways for now. This is going to give him a lot of offensive power. He's pretty far behind as far as tech goes. But just the amount of damage output he's going to have is pretty staggering.
Yeah, his DPS and survivability will both be pretty good here as he attacks in toward TLO's probably natural first. We'll have to see if he's going to change that up. He's got one sentry along for the ride as well for Guardian Shield, perhaps, if a bunch of roaches show up or Mutalisks. So he should be soaking a little bit of damage from that. He is going to drop two forward pylons just in case. And Brown is going to move forward now with quite a lot of stalkers. TLO does have 30 supply more, but a lot of it is tied up and a lot of it is drones.
That is an absurd number of stalkers already, and they are quite powerful with plus two attacks. You should be able to replenish these very quickly as well. This queen is just going to die immediately up at the front.
Oh, look at that.
This base is already under fire.
He can drop a pylon all the way up here. The creep is not joined together. That's actually huge for Brown to be able to drop a pylon this close to his Zerg opponent. That fourth base doesn't stand a chance at the moment. TLO is trying to get rid of all these pylons that he's been dropping along the way, but these stalkers really don't need to concern themselves with these eggs. They can just continue to move on here. There's a lot of Zerglings coming in now. Infested Terran getting dropped all over the place. The stalkers obviously have Blink, though, so if Brown's control is good enough, he will be able to save these as they get lower on health. And the roaches really are going to be the primary targets here. The Infested Terrans will eventually die on their own. They do decent DPS, but the roaches are a lot more important if they can manage to power them down. They do cost a lot more, and obviously they're tying up a lot of supply, but Brown already looking very, very good here. Another big Blink up right on top of the Infestors, no less, and he is actually going to be able to take out all of them. GG from Liquid TLO, Slayer's Dark and Slayer's Brown taking out five of Liquid's best. and winning the match 5-2 here.
That's right. Dark started things right off, taking out Hero and then taking out Tasia right afterwards. And then, of course, the remaining members did all fall to Brown. So a very convincing performance by Slayers. That's just what they needed to start making their way back into the division. Like we said, that does put them at 2-1 now. Unfortunately, Liquid has gone 0-3. They will be playing the up-and-down matches into the contender division. So best of luck to them there. But now Slayers does have a respectable map score. It looks like they're at 11-10 overall. Mm-hmm. MVP has a little bit better map score going that was going into this match. So if they have a very convincing win over Evil Geniuses, then they'll be in great position to keep moving forward. But if they lose to Evil Geniuses, then who knows? Maybe we'll have EG and Slayers advance.
Well, if they lose to Evil Geniuses, then they'll be 1-2.
Yep.
So
that's what I'm saying.
That's definitely what would happen. But MVP, if they win... Okay, so they're sitting at 9-8 now. If Slayers is at 11-10, you said?
Yes.
So MVP, if they win at all, they're going to have 5 added on to that, so their map score would already just be better.
Right.
Because they did better in the maps in the match that they did lose. So MVP versus Evil Geniuses has a lot of consequences for both MVP and Slayers. Next week will be that last match for the division, I believe. So, it should be. It's the only one remaining.
Yes.
So, that's definitely next week. And then tomorrow, I believe we have StarTail versus TSL.
Yes,
because last week we had a little bit of a replay issue, had to swap StarTail versus Prime with StarTail versus TSL. We got the right replays in now, so we're ready to go for tomorrow. StarTail versus TSL should be an awesome match.
There we go. So, and then in the latter part of the week, we also have Contender Division action. We're going to start finding out who these teams that are moving into the up and downs are actually going to face going into next season. So that is it for us tonight, guys. Please do check us out on Twitter, Facebook, or YouTube. Is at IGN Pro League on any of those services. If you're on Twitch.tv, please do follow us on the page. We really do appreciate it. It really does help us out. We're also giving away some TD Esports goodies, a mouse and a mouse pad over on tinyurl.com/IPLTTEsports3. That's the number 3 again. tinyurl.com/IPLTTEsports3. And please, go ahead and tweet at TD Esports' Twitter accounts and let them know how much you appreciate them being involved in esports and giving us these prizes to give to you.
Yep. And all I've got to say is one more little mention about Shoot Mania, as we're still doing a lot of content at 6 p.m. Pacific every night of the week at twitch.tv/IPLShootMania. We're still giving away lots of beta keys for that game if you're interested at go.ign.com/IPLShootMania. You can grab yourself a free 30-day beta key for that game, and please tune into those broadcasts as well. That's all I've got. Follow Ask Joshy, follow at Kevin Naki, and we'll tweet a bunch of stuff about StarCraft, Shoot Mania, and Magic as we attend that event this weekend.
And because actually it's number 1 on r/StarCraft right now, that TSL Hyun has actually had his 9-week reign on IPL Fight Club. Thanks very much to everyone who has been tuning in for those. And we are actually going to have Essun, the former Brood War player, who's going to be the next combatant to try and take down TSL Hyun.
Interesting. I'm just learning this now. So Essun is a Protoss or Terran player?
Protoss player.
Okay, so we've seen Hyun take out Gumiho and Beyond in the last 2 weeks, so it's time for Protoss to have another shot. We can see how Essun will do on Monday. But that's everything we got for today. Join us tomorrow for more Premier IPTL.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the bright lights and beautiful city